Hello students, we will start with the previous few lectures. What was handled was about what is clustering, then types of clustering and different types of clusters. Now we will start with the different clustering algorithms. So the first one, the most easiest one to deal with, is the k-means algorithm. I have just put forward the written the steps over here of the k-means algorithm. Okay, now what the k-means algorithm does, we will see. Here we first initially choose k initial centroids. Now this k is nothing else but the number of clusters. It can be any value. It is again a user defined parameter. So based on some distance calculation, we will start assigning the values to the different centroids. Okay. So here I have some, these are the numbers which are given to me. Okay. And then I am taking k is equal to 2. That means I am going to have 2 clusters. So initially I have to choose 2 centroids. Now what is my objective? I will have 2 clusters. I have to put these numbers into the 2 clusters. So let this be cluster k1. Let this be cluster k2. Okay. Now I have to put these numbers into the 2 clusters k1 and k2 based on some centroid value. So let us assume, I am assuming the first centroid value as 4. You can choose anything, okay. And the second centroid value I have taken as 12. You can choose any random value for centroid. Since there are only 2 clusters, I have taken 2 values. Now I have to find the distance between each of these numbers to this centroid. So 2 is closer to 4 than to 12. So it will come into the first cluster K1. 3, the difference between 3 and 4 is how much? 1. Whereas 3 and 12 is 9. So this has got lesser distance. So it will come into the cluster K1. Again 4 and 4. 4 is closer to 4. So it will come into the cluster K1. Now from 10 onwards, all these numbers are closer to the cluster 12. So from 10 onwards, all these numbers go into the cluster K2. This is the first iteration. In the next iteration, again now we have to recompute the centroids. How I will compute the centroids now? It will be the average of the different numbers. So I have 3 numbers here, 2, 3 and 4. Their average is equal to 3. So this next centroid in the second iteration, it becomes M1 will be equal to 3. Now here when I come to, again if I take the average of all these numbers, it is total is 108. 6 numbers are there. So 108 by 6 is 18. So the second centroid is 18. Now I have to go back and check from this initial set. Remember, from this initial set, you have to check if these numbers are closer to 3 or to 18. So again, I check the difference. 2 minus 3, it is closer to 3. 2 is closer to 3, so it will come into the first cluster. Again, 3 is closer to 3, comes into the first cluster. 4 is closer to 3, comes into the first cluster. This way, 10 is closer to 3, 10 minus 3 is 7, comes into the first cluster. 11 is closer to 18, so it comes into the second cluster. Difference between 11 and 18 is lesser than the difference between 11 and 3, so it comes into the second cluster. 12 is closer to 18, comes into the second cluster. This way, all these numbers are closer to 18, so they come into the second cluster. Now I have redefined the clusters. Remember, earlier iteration 10 was in the second cluster. Now 10 has come to the first cluster. Okay. Again, I have to third iteration. I recompute my mean. So what is this now? The centroid, it is the average of these 4 numbers. I get it as a decimal. I am rounding it to 5. 4.75, rounding it to 5. Here also I get 19.6. I will round it to 20. So these two become the centroids of my third cluster. Okay. Now again, I have to check. These numbers are closer to 5 or they are closer to 20. If they are closer to 5, I will put them in the first cluster. If they are closer to 20, I'll put them in the second cluster. So when the same operation repeats, I get the first cluster compared to the earlier iteration, 11 and 12 will be the new entrance in the first cluster. And here you have only 3 numbers, 20, 25 and 30. Now you compute the mean again. Okay, repeat the process. When I repeat the process, I get 7 as the mean over here, 25 as the centroid over here. Now again you compute the difference between these numbers and 7, and these numbers are 25. Whichever they are closer to, recompute the clusters K1 and K2. So we get K1 equal to 2, 3, 4, 10, 11, 12 and K2 equal to 20, 25 and 30. Now I will again compute the centroid. What is the centroid I am getting now? Is there any difference between the clusters now? Here also it was 2, 3, 4, 10, 11, 12. Here also the same thing it is. Here K2 is 20, 25, 30. Here also 20, 25, 30. So when I compute the centroid, your M1 will be 7, same thing. M2 will be 25. It is the same as the previous iteration. So once we get the same values, we stop and we define that these two are the final clusters. So the final clusters are K1 is equal to 2, 3, 4, 10, 11, 12 and K2 is equal to 20, 25 and 30. So this is how we execute the K-means algorithm. So what do we do in K-means algorithm? Initially, we select K points as the initial centroid. So here we took two points, M1 and M2 as the initial centroid. Then we form K clusters. So here the second statement is form K clusters by assigning each point to the closest centroid. So we check now each point. 2 is closer to 4. So I'll assign it to the cluster K1. 3 is closer to 4. So I'll assign it to the cluster K1. This way each point you have to check which centroid it is closer to and assign it to the cluster. Then recompute the centroid of each cluster. After this, again I'm computing the centroid of the cluster. So I got M1 equal to 3, M2 equal to 18. Now, until centroids do not change, so until I get different centroids, keep computing it and repeat the process. So this is what a K-means algorithm does. I hope it is clear how your clustering algorithm, K-means clustering algorithm works. Okay, similarly we have a second example over here. There we had only one set of values. Here we have two values, height and weight. Okay, now height and weight is there. So here how we are going to compute is, I am taking this as my, again your K value, two clusters we are computing for. So your K1 initial centroid is 185 and 72. And second centroid is 170 and 56. So I have to compute the distance of each of these numbers from these two numbers. Okay. So take the third row, 168 and 60. You check if 168 and 60, it belongs to K1 or to K2. Okay. So how I'll do, you have a formula for Euclidean distance. It is nothing but square root of x2 minus x1 the whole squared plus y2 minus y1 the whole squared. This is the formula for Euclidean distance. So applying that formula, x2 and y2 are the new values. So my new values, that is the third row. I have to check if the third row is closest to the first row or to the second row. Because the first row value I've taken as a first cluster, second row value I've taken as a second cluster. Okay, that is the centroid value. So I'm computing 168 minus 185. Whole squared plus 60 minus 72 whole squared. You get 20.80. Then 168 minus 170 whole squared plus 60 minus 56 whole squared. You get 4.48. So the lesser value among the two is 4.48. That means this value of 168 and 60 is closer to cluster K2. So in K2, I will have, I've already put the second cluster. Now your third cluster also comes. Okay. Now in K1, initially I had only cluster 1. Now which cluster has changed now? Cluster K2 has changed. Okay. Because earlier there was only the second row in it. Now even the third row has come into it. Right. So now since K2 has changed, what we have to do? We have to recompute the centroid for K2. How we will recompute the centroid is, your K2 initially was how much? 170. Now what was added? 168. So 170 plus 168 by 2. 56 plus 60 by 2. So 170 plus 168 by 2. It is 169. 56 plus 60 by 2 is 58. So now your second centroid will be 169 and 58. So the next value, the fourth value what I compute. What is the fourth value? 179 and 68. So this should be computed with reference to the first cluster, that is this one, and the new centroid.